First, Brian, I want to congratulate you on receiving the Scales of Justice Award. It's wonderful that you're being honored for all the years of dedication, commitment to equal justice, pro bono, public interest law. I got to tell you, it fills my heart with joy and pride.
Thank you, Judge. It really, really means a lot to me.
And we go back a long ways. You appeared before me as an assistant U.S. attorney, and then we got to work together on the first nonprofit we were founders of, Just the Beginning Pipeline Organization. You had a passion and an energy then, and you have it now. How have you been able to keep that passion and energy up? What keeps you going?
Well, Judge, it's pretty easy. First, I have people like you in my life. So if anybody knows you, you know you can't help but have a lot of energy. But I keep it going because I know there's so much work to do.
Part of that energy was how you were raised and the values that were given to you. Could you
Absolutely.
Share with us who instilled those values and how you were inspired by your upbringing?
I was raised by an incredible set of parents, my mother and my father. But my father was somebody who was quiet and how he went and served. He was an early black banker in the city of Chicago, and he saw a need and an opportunity for other young black executives to come into the banking field. And I came from a mother whose work ethic was impeccable. She would always tell me, do what you say you're gonna do, and don't disappoint.
And so you stand on their shoulders.
Oh, absolutely.
You honor their history
by
what you're doing. And you decided not to do the banker route. You decided to go to law school. Why did you decide law was the place you needed to be?
Well, it actually comes down to something very simple. I couldn't add. So
banking was out.
Banking was out. You know, it was odd. I didn't know any lawyers, didn't have lawyers in my family, but I always saw them as pillars of the community, people that were trusted, people that were expected to do more. That's really all it was. I saw them as revered people in the community that had an obligation to serve the community. That's where it started.
One thing that your parents taught you and that you remain committed to is diversity, equity, and inclusion. How has that been reflected in your career?
You know, I've been through a lot. As a black man in corporate America, I've been through it all, and I can tell you there's about 10 of us that could write books on it all. And it really boils down to the empathy factor. And so I'd always thought if I ever got in a position to lead and manage people, that I would never want someone to feel excluded. I would never want someone to feel less than themselves, or that something as a result of their gender, ethnicity, orientation was a deciding factor in their success. And so I've led my life that way. That I was never going to make someone feel less than. And I learned that very early on.
You've never forgotten those like your dad who helped those who were voiceless, who needed opportunity. Yeah. So with that blessing comes responsibility. Could you speak to that responsibility?
Absolutely. You know, I always try to make sure I give people my time because that's the one precious item I can't give away. And I give it away as much as I can to people who are definitely looking for some guidance, looking for some help, looking for opportunity.
And so your focus on pro bono, because you give it away personally, you encourage your team to do it.
Absolutely.
Why is it so easy for you to support Equal Justice Works, to say yes to Equal Justice Works?
Well, first of all, Judge, it's the amazing work that the organization does, the fellows that they support. It's in line with our values as a corporation. It's in line with my values as a leader. And so every time Equal Justice Works comes calling, I've been answering, and I will continue to do so. The fellows inspire me. The organization inspires me. And so it's very easy for me to support that kind of effort.
So the role of the corporate lawyer in public interest, could you talk about that?
Certainly. You know, it's sometimes a challenge because we don't have the flexibility some of our law firm partners have. So as the GC, I try to give our teams the opportunity to go do that. We make sure that there's something they're invested in and interested in. I'm so happy that we're supporting a fellow for Equal Justice Works, and she's doing tremendous work.
Is that Sabrina?
That's Sabrina,
Bernadelle?
Yes. Yes, and she is a dynamo. She reminds me of you, Judge. Lots of energy and just an incredible woman doing incredible work out there. She's working on challenges with black girls in schools, around the adultification of black women and really trying to change things legislatively, trying to change policing in schools, because the numbers and the staggering effect of expulsions of young girls is staggering. Something I knew nothing about. In my own community, I knew nothing about it. And so Sabrina's been just doing amazing work both at the state and federal level to try to deal with this issue.
And when we look at our fellows across the board and across the years, our Equal Justice Works fellows, that heart and that empathy and that ability to give voices to the voiceless, how much does that matter in a public interest lawyer?
Talking to those fellows and seeing the passion in what they're doing, selfless work that they're doing, that really makes a difference. That's what gets me going. That's what got me hooked with Equal Justice Works. It's the special part about this organization, that there's so much great work that these fellows are doing.
What's your final word to our fellows, our wonderful, amazing, groundbreaking fellows?
Just keep doing what you're doing. Keep pushing, because without you making a difference, we would be in a difficult place in many spaces. I think about our own fellow. Keep doing what you're doing, Sabrina. Keep knocking it out of the park. We're here to support you.
So just as they inspire you, you inspire us, Brian. You have that light in your eyes, that light for justice, that light for equal justice, to give voice to the voiceless, to do everything within your power to make Equal Justice Works.
Thank you, real. Judge. That means the world for me to hear from you. Thank you.
Thank you, dear. Thank you.